ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most gracious, the most merciful. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon all conditions. We send blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his companions, his household, all those who struggled and strove through the generations to preserve the goodness, to teach it to us, and to convey it in a way that today we are seated here in this beautiful masjid, in this lovely, lovely place known as Kaduna, in the blessed country of Nigeria, mashallah. We thank Allah. For me, it is a dream come true to be able to sit in such a lovely masjid, which is the house of Allah, and to be able to address my sisters, my mothers, my daughters, and possibly some of my granddaughters. May Allah bless you all. Before I commence, I want to acknowledge the sisters who are outside, those who did not fit or could not have made it into the masjid. We acknowledge you. May Allah bless you. Ameen. Your reward is written, and the sisters sitting in the masjid have said Ameen very loudly for you. MashaAllah. That having been said, my dearest mothers and sisters, I want to dive straight into the topic that I've been given, and that is family values, towards instilling these family values. Do you know, on the globe today, there is a trend of people detaching from their families. There is a trend of people believing that your happiness lies in your distance from your own family. I want to highlight to you the pros and cons, and I want to take you through what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has actually taught us. Firstly, who made you? Allah. Who created you? Allah. When He created you, He had a choice. He could have created you in any way He wanted. We could have grown like the trees. We could have been like any other creature. He could have made us separated, but He decided to create us in a certain way. This is why in Surah An-Nisa, right at the beginning, Allah reminds us of how He chose to create us.
يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمُ الَّذِي خَلَقَكُم مِّن نَّفْسٍ وَاحِدَةٍ وَخَلَقَ مِنْهَا زَوْجَهَا وَبَثَّ مِنْهُمَا رِجَالًا كَثِيرًا وَنِسَاءً وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ الَّذِي تَسَاءَلُونَ بِهِ وَالْأَرْحَامَ إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَانَ عَلَيْكُمْ رَقِيبًا.
Amazing verse. We heard it a lot, I'm sure. And it has in it the crux of how Allah made us, or what Allah chose in terms of a path through which we would be on earth. He says, O people. Normally Allah says, O you who believe. But in some places in the Quran, He says, O people, because the message is for all people, even if you don't believe. He says, O people, be conscious of the one who made you. Constantly think. Today I received a message from someone to say, you know, I have these atheistic beliefs. And I said, you know, where were you 2 years before you were born? Try to think deeply about that question, and it will make you realize. Another thing is, look at yourself. You have a brain, you have eyes, you have a nose, you have ears, you have a feeling, you have a heart, you have so much you love and you dislike, and so on. When you die, do you really think that such a complicated system, that is more complicated than any computer on earth or any technological advancement apparatus on earth, can it just come to an end suddenly, gone, boom, and it's no more? we're not going to meet again, we're not going to see you, etc. On earth, I might not know you personally, but trust me, when we make it to the other side, we will know each other personally. It's very possible, if we want to at the time, very possible. There has to be something more grand than what we have right now. So the thought of this will drive you back to Allah. O you who believe, that's what Allah says in many places in the Quran where the message is specialized. This place Allah is saying, O people, be conscious of He who made you. Think about the one who made you. Alladhi khalaqakum. Ittaqu rabbakum. Be conscious of or develop a relationship with the one who made you. You know the term Rabbun, it has to do with the nourishing, the cherishing, the providing, the protecting, the curing, and to be in control of you and your sustenance and everything else that is inclusive in the term Rabbun. Allah says, think about your Rabb. Develop a good relationship with your Rabb, with the one who made you, right? Think about it. You will never, no matter how sophisticated your brain might be, no matter how educated you may think you are, you will never ever be able to distance yourself from He who made you, whom you are going to return to. Because, like I said earlier, where were you 2 years before you were born, and where will you be the moment you leave the earth? Where will you be? Subhanallah. So it's important. Allah says, Alladhi khalaqakum. Who is your Rabb? The one who created you. From what? From one soul. He created you from one soul. It started with one, just one. Allah made one. What happened after He created that one? So there are several narrations that make mention of it. I know there are some who contest it. Remember, my dearest mothers and sisters, there are people who don't believe in the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ at all. So in order for us to distinguish ourselves from them, we are known as Ahlus Sunnah, which means we are not only Quraniyun, we believe in the Sunnah as well. The term Ahlus Sunnah, I'm sure you have heard that, right? It comes from the fact that we believe in the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ, in the hadith, in his lifestyle, in the fact that it is a sacred revelation from Allah as well. We believe in the hadith, we are known as Ahlus Sunnah. Then there are some people who do not believe in the Sahaba. Do you know that? They say the Sahaba were all cheats, a'udhu billah. They say they were criminals, a'udhu billah. They say they were hypocrites, alhamdulillah. They handpick five or six and they say besides these, all the rest were, we discount them. In order to protect ourselves from that belief, we are known as wal jama'ah. We believe in the group. The group of who? Jama'atul Sahaba. We believe in the group of the companions as well. So when someone says, I am Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, it means I believe in the Quran and the Sunnah and the companions of the Prophet ﷺ. To me, they are my role models and I take from them. So we are part of Ahlus Sunnati wal Jama'ah. I hope you understand. I've worded it very simply for you to know forever what is the meaning of the term Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. There are people who say La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah, which means they are Muslim. But they may not be from Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah because there may be something wrong with one of these two things that I have spoken about. So I am saying this because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us, I created you from one soul. Some people say, no, that's not true. A'udhu billah. And Allah says, wa khalaqa minha zawjaha. We created from it, its spouse. How Allah created it, I don't know, you don't know, we were only told. Were you there to witness it? No. Was I there to witness it? No. So how do I know it? From the hadith. I am Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah. I take the hadith. Do you understand the point? So if you look at the Jews and the Christians and the Muslims, they share a common belief that Hawa, may peace be upon her, was created from Adam. Sometimes you have some women who say, no, that is very insulting. You know, how can you say I was created from a rib? Well, I want to tell you something. Adam was created from dust. Which is worse? Which is worse, dust or the rib? Dust, right or wrong? It's got nothing to do with what is worse and what is not worse. If we see dust on the windowsill, we want to literally, the term in English is called to dust it, which means to get rid of the dust. We are created from something we don't like ourselves. Do you know that? We are created from dust. If there is dust here, dust there, what will you do? You'll hit it with a cloth, you'll hit it with a little duster and dust it off. But you were created from that. If you have mud on your fingers, you can't wait to wash it. If you have mud on your own clothes, you say, take it out. But you were created from the same mud. Subhanallah, Rabbil Alameen. Look at Allah. So don't be insulted by what Allah created you from. That is besides the point. Totally besides the point. Allah did not give you a say in it. So don't start arguing with others about it. Forget about it. Just say, yes, we know we were created from whatever Allah created us from, because Allah chose to create us from it. Right now, I am who I am because Allah made me. But I know that the root is one. So what happened? If you look at what Ibn Kathir, rahimahullah, says in a book that he has compiled known as Al-Bidayah wa Nihaya, he speaks about how Adam alayhi salam was lonely. He was lonely. And when he was lonely, he needed some form of companionship. And so he prayed to Allah to alleviate that loneliness. And so one day Allah blessed him with who? Hawa. MashaAllah, MashaAllah, Tabarakallah. Allah blessed him. And SubhanAllah, SubhanAllah. It was such a great blessing. From the two, they gave comfort to each other. And I'm going to cut a long story short. They actually helped each other get closer to Allah after they had committed a sin together. You know, people argue and debate. They say, these women, they lead us astray. You know, they look at Eve, Hawa. She made Adam eat from the forbidden fruit. That's not true. She didn't make someone eat. It was Shaitan who made both of them eat. You follow the point? So don't let one blame you and say, you know what, you ladies, you are a problem. You are not a problem. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ease. So it was Shaitan. He attacked both of them. He convinced both of them. He tried with both of them. They ate. Where do I get that from? Allah says, فَأَكَلَا مِنْهَا فَبَدَتْ لَهُمَا سَوْآتُهُمَا. They both ate from it. Subhanallah. Allah didn't say one ate and then he told the other one come eat, or she told the other one come eat. No. They both did the wrong thing. They regretted it because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exposed them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cover us. And Allah says, well, they sought forgiveness. We forgave them. We sent them onto earth and we started giving them children. The reproduction started not in while they were in what was known as Jannah. Jannah.